Hello there, Alder here, and today I just got back from Star Wars Force Awakens. Awakens! Also, before you watch this video, just to let you know, there will be spoilers. Lots of spoilers. All the spoilers! Spoilers! I'm gonna put a link for something else here. Of one of my theories, so you can go check that out if you like. This though is kind of a review of The Force Awakens. Now, I've been waiting for this movie since I was very much younger. As soon as I had found out that Disney had bought, Star Wars franchise, I knew for a fact they were going to come out with another Star Wars, as most people did, and I knew that it was going to be good, and I was actually surprised as to how good it was. Does it match up to the original trilogy? No. Does it outdo the prequels? Oh, fuck yeah, CK. It outdoes the prequels by far, easily. For one, the fact that they relied on practical effects, the fact that they used practical effects throughout the entire movie was fucking amazing! Oh, fucking amazing! They did have some CGI. Even the original trilogy had some sorts of CGI. But it wasn't like slapped in your face. They had one character that was CGI, and she played a very bit role. She was very small in there. The main characters, Rey and Finn, fucking on point. They were good actors. Like, they were good actors. I was very happy about that. As well, just so you know, the bad guys in this movie, the First Order, are not the Empire. They're different. They appear to be two completely separate forces. And something tells me that this is a completely different part of the galaxy. A part of the galaxy that has nothing to do with where the rebellion and the Empire took place. Which would be very interesting, and I really like that idea. I'll actually get to a little bit of a theory that I have on that a little bit later, but for now, by the way, the movie is a good 2 hours and some minutes long, but it still feels as though it's a little short. Not that the movie itself is short, but that scenes are a little short. Like, they're not that there could be a little more to the scenes, but there is a little more to the scene. Which is very interesting. It makes me think when the movie actually comes out, there might be an extended edition, which would be fucking awesome! Hello! It'll make Star Wars weekends much more fucking difficult, though. Oh my god. Hello. Very excited. So, the main character appears to be on Tatooine, and throughout the first trailer, since I only ever watched the first trailer, was good at that point. Throughout the very first trailer, it looked like the movie was going to take place on Tatooine. And I was like, oh, well, this is interesting. As well, Finn, they kind of explain where he came from.
Oh, and they talk about where Kylo Ren comes from, too. Did not see that shit coming.
My god, I'm literally just spouting out nonsense in all of this excitement.
Anyways,
so the two meet up, and the amount of comic relief in the movie is proper. Like, it feels okay. So you know how in the original trilogy, it was just Han Solo said a witty thing, everyone went boo, and that was about it. Yeah, boring conversation. Anyways, he improv that line. It was cool. It sounded good. I'll see you in hell. He improv that line. It sounded good, and it was cool. And then the prequels came out, and there was fucking comic relief in Jar Jar Binks, and then R2-D2 and C-3PO, and it was bullshit!
It was the part that I hated the most.
But in this movie, the comic relief, the funny moments feel like, it isn't forced in. It feels like it's from the people. Like, this, it, they themselves are people that have this kind of humor in them. And it's them being who they are. It's not them forcing a joke. It's not them relying on some bullshit. I will say, I think there was a little too much of it and not quite enough, and not focusing on this very heartfelt scene. And there's a couple very heartfelt scenes. Oh my god, there, a lot of the parts of this movie could have been short movies all their own, and I would have fucking loved it. It's still very, 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 very good. Do not get me wrong at all. The TIE Fighters. Oh my god, they're competent. The TIE Fighters in this movie are good pilots, and you see them being good pilots. You see them being badass. Oh, they're badasses, and I love it. And you see the Stormtroopers being badasses. God, I wish you could actually see a fight of between just Stormtroopers and a group of fucking rebels, but you don't really get to see that. You kind of get to see it a little bit, but not really. And I would have loved to see that. I guess you do in the beginning of the movie. In the beginning of the movie, you kind of get to see that. In the beginning of the movie, you kind of get to see Stormtroopers being badasses and killing the fuck out of some people. Anyways, this is not the Empire. I want to remind everybody that these guys, I would actually look at and be like, no, those are bad guys. Those guys are bad. Those are bad guys. I'm the kind of person that looks at the Empire and goes, no, they're the good guys. The Rebellion are terrorists. The Rebellion are bad guys. The Empire are good guys. In this movie, those bad guys are bad guys. They're bad guys. Oh my god. Oh my god, Kylo Ren. He's so cool. So, you have Darth Vader, who's this beautiful, imposing, hardcore, supreme badass. And you're thinking, no one can fucking live up to him. Holy shit, no one can live up to him. Kylo Ren does not live up to him. He is a qualified successor. He doesn't need to live up to Vader. He is the successor to Vader. He is evil like Vader. Okay, so I do have a few points of contention, though, with this movie. The big bad thing. The big bad thing that they have. It seemed like they were trying to one-up the Death Star. And that bugged me. But then I remembered their name. And I was just like, oh, maybe they came before the Empire. Maybe they've been around for a while. Well, this is interesting. So I have a slight theory that maybe not only does this take part of in a completely different part of the galaxy, but that it is, these guys were around before even the Empire. Because if not, then it makes very little sense for them to have this kind of fucking technology. But we'll find out. It will probably all be explained. Something else that you'll see in this movie that is pretty fucking awesome is another non-force user uses a lightsaber. We have Han Solo using the lightsaber to cut open the Tauntaun in episode 5. We have General Grievous using lightsabers to fight off Obi-Wan in episode 3. Now we have Finn using a lightsaber to actually fight Kylo Ren and to murderate some stormtroopers in The Force Awakens. And it's actually pretty awesome. And we see him get into this fight with another stormtrooper that has something like, he has like a force baton. Like, it looks like a baton. Not a force baton, a vibro baton. And you know what that means, right? Vibro weapons are fucking viable, and they have them. Well, of course, they already had them in Star Wars, because we see them with the fucking crazy asteroids with General Grievous. But you see what I'm saying? Anyways, oh my god, and the fight they have are just so fucking cool. It's so fucking cool. That's what I have to say about this movie. It is so fucking cool. It is a cool movie. I would put it far, far, far ahead of all of the prequels, but still behind the original trilogy. On a scale of 1 to 7, 1 being, in my opinion, Revenge of the Sith, and 7 being Empire Strikes Back for how good each thing is, I would put it firmly at a 4. That's really confusing sounding, but I'm going to leave it in there. It's a 4 on the scale. On a scale of 1 to 10 for how good it actually was, I would say it's about an 8. An 8.5, maybe even a 9. It was well done. Oh my god. The effects? Beautiful. I loved them. The story? Pretty goddamn good. The twist? Well, if I hadn't have had that fucking spoiler right before I went to go see fucking Star Wars, there's a fucking spoiler that spoiled the fucking movie. Shut the fucking die, the fucking. If I hadn't seen that spoiler before going to see The Force Awakens, I would have put it at probably a 9. I felt dread. While it was leading up to that point, I felt dread! Holy shit! The falling action was a little long for me. And if you don't know what falling action is, it is after the climax happens and then it goes through everything else. So that would be like Sam and Frodo throw the ring into the Death Star, it blows up and destroys all the Borg. And then everything else after that would be falling action. A lot of people were wondering what the movie might disprove. What the movie might throw... Because after the idea came out that everything that wasn't in the movies was legend, everything that wasn't in the Clone Wars cartoon was legend, all of that, everything that has to do with that, it was called into question. So what does this movie disprove? Does it say anything about Han Solo's children? Yes. Sadly, every single book you've read that has Han Solo's children in them, basically now debunked. Kind of. Or at least the names have changed. One of the two. Same thing with Luke Skywalker's son. So yeah, that's gone. That's debunked. A lot of books are still completely in legend. They are not non-canon. But a lot of books are now non-canon. Oh! Ooh! Ah! Speaking of which... Oh, the revelation feels so good when I saw it in the movie. Supreme Leader Snoke is not fucking Jar Jar, because Abrams isn't fucking stupid. Oh god, when I saw that movie, I sighed. I let out a sigh of because something that was just throbbing in my heart going that it would get to that fucking scene and there'd be fucking Jar Jar sitting just there and I was going, but it wasn't. It wasn't, and I used that to have a hearty giggle at the foe that I slayed in my very first fury. I was a 12-year-old girl, I used to laugh like that. Hearty and fruitful, just like my heart is. Who from the original cast was in it? The main cast. For, I guess, in appearing order, Han Solo, Chewbacca, and you actually get to see some of, you get to hear about Han Solo's, what he's been doing since Return of the Jedi. R2-D2, and Luke Skywalker. So So you have all of the main original cast. Do I think that any of them will be in the next one? I think pretty much all of them will be in the next one, except for one of them, for a reason. And I know I screamed about spoilers in the beginning of this, and I've given a lot of spoilers. I'm not gonna say who or what just in case. Go see the movie. Seriously, the fucking twist is tasteful. It's beautiful. And what's more, it was correct. It was proper. Holy shit, was it worth it. Oh my god. Go see it. For realsies. Go see it. It is fantastic. If you really like Knights of the Old Republic, you will love this movie. It's not that it follows the storyline or anything. It's just like, they feel similar. Like, they feel like, wow, these are cool. I like these. Like, it feels like the person that wrote the script kind of played a little bit of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic and was like, I really like this. And kind of views that as a bit of inspiration. Yeah. Anyways. I think I've talked enough. I've talked for, Jesus, almost 30 minutes about this fucking movie. It's gonna be fun to edit. I'm gonna try and get this thing down to 15 minutes. Anyways, I will talk to you guys in the next episode. And always remember, no matter how good you are, no matter how pure you are of heart, even your offspring can become monstrous.